We've been talking about being disciplined and knowing how to rule over our emotions. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians, we are unspiritual when we're under the control of ordinary impulses. And that's the way so many people are today. They just let their feelings run their lives. If they feel like getting upset, then they're upset. If they feel like telling somebody off, they just tell them off. They feel like being lazy, they're lazy. They feel like being depressed, and they go around all depressed. But friends, we cannot just act on these emotional impulses and expect to have any kind of victory in our lives. Feelings will lead us astray. Feelings can get us into trouble. And throughout life, you're going to have plenty of opportunities to lose your temper and say things you regret. You're going to get up some mornings and feel like being depressed, feel like going around in a bad mood. At times you'll get caught in traffic and feel like being impatient, feel like getting upset. See, the feelings are always going to be there. But we've got to learn how to follow wisdom and do what we know is right and not just follow our feelings around. I heard somebody say, I can feel my emotions rising, but I made a decision not to get on board. And that's a good way to look at it. Just because you can feel those emotions doesn't mean you have to get on board. And to be disciplined means to do the right thing when you feel like doing the wrong thing. When you feel like saying something that you know you shouldn't say, no, don't get on board. And somebody offends you and you feel like holding a grudge, no, discipline that emotion and learn to forgive them anyway. If things aren't going your way and you kind of feel like being discouraged, you feel like having a pity party, no, you've got to learn to discipline the negative feelings and keep a good attitude anyway. We have to understand it's when we do the hard things in life, that's when God is developing our character. That's when He's doing a work in us. When we're willing to apologize, even though it wasn't our fault, that's when we're growing up. When somebody's rude to us and we just bite our tongue and walk away, that's when we're passing the test. Somebody offends us and we just don't let it bother us. We just take the high road. That's when we're really maturing. It's in these difficult times God is building our character. But the problem today is too many people are not willing to pay the price to walk in victory. They don't want to suffer. They don't want to be inconvenienced. They just want to take the easy way out. And you know as well as I do, the easiest thing to do is to just let our flesh have its way. But friends, there is no such thing as fast food maturity. If you want to grow up and experience God's best, it's going to take some hard work. It's hard to love people when they're not being nice to us. It's hard to just overlook an insult. It's hard to keep a good attitude and be patient when nothing's going your way. Sometimes it hurts to keep the flesh under. Sometimes it's going to make us uncomfortable. But I read where there are two kinds of pain in life. One is the pain of discipline, the other is the pain of regret. And the pain of discipline weighs ounces, but the pain of regret weighs tons. And if we live a lazy, undisciplined life, and we just give in to our feelings, and we act on these emotional impulses, we're going to make very poor choices that we regret later on. We would be much better off to just discipline ourselves right now, so that later on, we don't have to carry that heavy load of regret. I mean, how many times have we acted on our emotions and said something that we know we shouldn't say, and later on, it ends up hurting us in that relationship? How many people today act on their emotions and they get involved in a relationship outside of their marriage, and later on, it ends up tearing the whole family apart? Friends, the pain of discipline is minuscule compared to the pain of regret. And the scripture says in Hebrews 12:11, no discipline at the time is pleasant, but later on, it's going to bring you a harvest of great things. And we need to be more concerned about later on than we are just feeling good right now. If you live on that shallow level of just always letting your flesh have its way, then I can tell you later on, you're going to have some major regrets. Because the seeds we sow today, we're going to reap in the future. If you allow yourself to just go around being upset and impatient and stressed out, later on it's going to catch up to you. Later on it's going to affect your health. If you go around rude and disrespectful, just always speaking your mind, later on you're not going to have any kind of meaningful relationships. If you just are loose in your morals and you just do whatever you feel like doing, well, it may give you some pleasure at the time, but later on, it's going to cost you a very heavy price. We need to learn to discipline ourselves today so that later on we can receive the great reward. Later on, we can receive all God has in store for us. See, God will only promote us as high as our character will take us. And we all want to go to new levels of victory, but we've got to prove to God that we can handle that promotion. And God is not going to put you in a position of greater leadership if you are not treating the people in your life right now with respect and honor. God is not going to increase you financially if you're not being a good steward of what God has already given you. If you're being lazy and not being faithful to do what you know you should be doing, then that's going to keep you stagnant. That's going to keep you from growing. And I'm not saying that God is not going to bless us if we have any weaknesses. No, none of us have arrived. What I'm saying today is we should all be growing. We should all be improving. If you had a problem with your temper 10 years ago and you have that same exact problem today, I can tell you that's keeping you from God's best. If you were impatient and easily upset 5 years ago and you're at that same place today, that's keeping God from increasing you. If you would just do your part and grow up a little bit and quit being ruled by your feelings, quit acting on these emotional impulses, if you do that, that's when God will begin to increase you. I remember one time many years ago when my dad was the pastor of the first little church we had here at Lakewood. It had about 100 members in it. And one day, out of the clear blue, my dad got this very mean letter from another minister. And in this letter, he basically just raked my dad over the coals. He accused him of doing a bunch of things that were totally untrue. He had his facts all messed up. He told my dad that he wasn't even fit for the ministry, and he should just resign the church, and on and on. Well, like most people, at first, it made my dad angry. He could feel those emotions rising up, and he made that mistake of getting on board. He thought, who does this guy think he is? He doesn't even know me. How dare him write me this letter? And Daddy just acted on those emotional impulses, and he sat down, and he wrote him back the meanest, nastiest letter he possibly could. He said, brother, you don't even know what you're talking about. You are so out of line. You should get your facts straight before you accuse me of all this wrongdoing. Then he sealed that envelope up, and he took it out to the end of the driveway, put it in the mailbox, and he mailed it. Man, he felt so much better. He got all that off his chest. Well, a couple of hours later, the Lord began to deal with him right down in here. He said, son, you really got him back, didn't you? Daddy said, yes, Lord, I did. I really let him have it. He said, you feel much better, don't you? Daddy said, yes, Lord, I feel great. I set the record straight. Then God said, son, what do you think I would have done if I would have received a letter just like that? Man, that really got my dad's attention. The more he thought about it, the more convicted he felt. He knew the right thing to do was to just let it go and forgive. He knew the right thing to do was to take the high road and overlook that offense. So Daddy marched right back out to the mailbox, and right before the postman came, he was able to get that letter out, and he just tore it to pieces. He did the right thing. But listen, that was not easy. He had to say no to his flesh. He didn't feel like doing that. No, he had to swallow his pride. But remember, it's when we make the right choices in the difficult times, that's when we're growing up. That's when we're developing character. And had Daddy not learned how to pass the test at that early stage and do what was right, whether he felt like it or not, how could God have ever entrusted him with a church this size? How could God have ever put him in a position to touch people all over the world? No, God will only promote us as high as our character will take us. If you're having difficult times today, instead of getting all bent out of shape, you need to see it as an opportunity to grow. You need to see it as an opportunity to develop character. God may be trying to do a work in you. And if you will pass that test and make the right choices, then God will promote you. And throughout life, God is going to, on purpose, allow us to go through certain situations to bring to light areas in our lives that we need to work on. If you find yourself always being around people that offend you and you're always getting your feelings hurt, well, there's a good chance that God is trying to teach you to quit being so touchy. God is trying to toughen you up a little bit. If you find yourself around people that are always rubbing you the wrong way, always irritating you, there's a good chance God is trying to teach you how to love the unlovely. He's trying to teach you a little bit about patience. Well, you say, Joel, I just can't stand my boss's personality. He gets on my nerves. I don't know when God is ever going to change him. No, have you ever thought about God may be trying to change you? God may have put him there on purpose, like iron sharpens iron, to refine you, to purify you. Well, God, if you just ever change these kids, that's why I'm always upset. They just won't obey me. Now, let me tell you a secret. God is not going to change your children until you first allow him to change yourself. And if you would quit spending all your time and energy focused on everybody around you, and instead look inside and allow God to do a work in you, then God will change the circumstances. Then he'll change those other people. But as long as we're just giving into our feelings, getting all upset, throwing temper tantrums, being impatient, as long as we're not passing the test, then we're going to have to take it over and over again. And the scripture says there in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12 from the Amplified, don't be surprised at the fiery trial that you're going through. It is only to test your quality. It is to test your character. And see, when we go through times of pressure, it shows us what we're really made of. It brings to light impurities in our character. It shows us areas we need to improve. And the sooner we cooperate with God and we're willing to change, the better off we're going to be. I know even in my own life, I'm a very neat and organized person. And I study at home, and I like my desk to be perfectly in order. It's just one of my pet peeves. I have an exact spot for my phone. I don't want it 2 inches this way or 2 inches that way. I have an exact place for it. I have a perfect place for my clock, a perfect place for my books. I like it to be perfectly in order. Well, every once in a while, when I'm not there, my lovely wife, Victoria, will come in. And when she uses the phone, she has this natural habit to just pull it a little closer to her so that the cord will reach a little easier. And when she's finished, she doesn't always put it back in the exact right spot. She doesn't move it much, maybe 4 or 5 inches. Most people wouldn't even notice, but for some reason, this would just really get on my nerves. It would really irritate me. And I was constantly telling Victoria, would you please leave my stuff alone? Or if you do use my phone, please put it back in the exact right spot. Well, the other day, I came home, I was tired, it had been a long day, and I walked into my office, and everything was moved. My phone was moved, my books were moved, I couldn't find my pen, and I could feel those emotions rising up. I could feel myself wanting to get upset. And I don't even know why I said it, but I just said underneath my breath, God, when are you ever going to change her? When are you going to ever cause her to quit moving my stuff? God is my witness. I heard a voice right down in here. It said, I'm going to change her as soon as you learn how to get over it.